Okay, let's see how you did with the concept map. We know that there are two copies of the human genome in every cell. And cells make up tissues, which make up organs, which make up the body. Cells, tissues, organs, and the body together manifest traits, which are influenced by the human genome. And we learned a bit about traits in lesson one. So the human genome resides in the cell, and it can be divided into the nuclear genome and the mitochondrial genome. The mitochondrial genome has one circular chromosome per mitochondria, and there are many mitochondria per cell. Now the nuclear genome, there's only one nucleus and one nuclear genome per cell, but each nuclear genome contains 23 pairs of linear chromosomes, and 22 pairs are called the autosomes. They're numbered based on their size from 1 to 22, 1 being the biggest and 22 being the smallest. But one pair of the 23 pairs of chromosomes are called sex chromosomes, and these determine the sex of the individual. Two X chromosomes will develop as a female, and an X and Y chromosome will develop as a male. All chromosomes in a cell are made of nucleic acid wrapped around histone proteins. Now there are two different types of nucleic acid, and one of them, DNA, is what makes up chromosomes. The other type, RNA, we'll learn more about in lesson three. DNA is composed of deoxynucleotides. There are four different types of deoxynucleotides that all differ in which nitrogenous base they contain. There is adenine, or A, which can base pair with thymine, or T. And cytosine, or C, can base pair with guanine, or G. Now, DNA is double-stranded and comes in a helical shape. But the double-stranded nature of DNA is held together by base pairs, which are formed by the nitrogenous bases. And one human genome, one copy, is made of 3 billion base pairs of DNA.